So I started out with penciling a circle on a cardboard box. And this cardboard box is from Amazon. You can use anything actually. I mean, any cardboard box that's lying around in the house. I took the biggest mixing bowl I have and drew out a circle. And because I have a set of three, I took the smallest steel bowl I had and then drew another circle inside it. Now, if you have a compass, that is much better. I just don't have a compass with me and hence I had to do this. And because of which, later on, as you'll see, I'll face a problem. I measured out the diameters of both the circle and the outer circle was 22 centimeters. So that means it has a radius of 11 centimeters just in case you want to use a compass. And for the inner circle, I'm not going to say anything because it was inaccurate. So what you basically need to do is you need to leave 4 centimeters from the outer circle inwards and then you are going to draw a circle. So that will be a radius of 7 centimeters. Now, because I did not have a compass, I had to mark 4 centimeters and then freehand a circle with a pencil, as you can see, which I'm not very good at, but I tried my best. And after you have both the circles, you are going to cut a kind of like a ring, not kind of, exactly like a flat disc. You're going to cut a disc, and the easiest way to do this is use a cutter, which also I did not have, so I just used a fruit knife or a paring knife, I think this is called. But if you have a cutter, please go ahead and use that, and then you're going to end up with a flat disc. Then we need about 4.5 strips of the same cardboard, and the width of these strips is supposed to be 2 centimeters each. And after that, I just started to use my glue gun and kind of stick this or fix this to the outer circle and the inner circle. And I started from the inner circle because it will be much easier to do. Like if you have first fixed the outer circle and then you go to the inner circle, it will be a little difficult, obviously, because it will be difficult for you to place the glue at the exact position. And while I'm saying this, I happen to have a glue gun at home. Now, if you do not have a glue gun, then you can use Fevicol, or you can even use Fevikwik or something that is a very strong glue, because if this is not strong, your ring light is not going to hold up very well, because you know we are going to put lead strips in here and you need something that is something sturdy to give structure to this whole thing, which is why also I did a layer of glue at the back of the circle, the points at which I had fixed the strips, because I wanted this to be able to hold its shape and also, you know, be a little stronger. Then, because we want a reflective surface, I'm using aluminium foil and we are going to cover the entire surface area with this, the exposed surface area, that is, which will be facing towards our face. And the reason for doing this is we want the surface to be as reflective as we can make it by our possible means, because the more light there is to reflect, the brighter your face or whatever you're filming is going to appear. Then I'm using lead strips, and these you can see are 12 volt wide lead strips, and this is a length of 5 meters. I did not end up using the entire 5 meters, I ended up using about 4.5. It also has an adapter at the back, which you can see. And then we are going to find a place where the two cardboard strips meet, so you can see that small place. And then I am going to pass through my wire through that, so that later on at the back we can fix the adapter. And then we are going to start to glue. The lead light basically has self-adhesive, so all you have to do is take out the tape at the back and start to fix your lead light. And you need to cover as much area as possible with the lead strip, okay? if possible, don't let any gaps and all see through, because the more light we are able to get in there, the brighter it's going to be. Once all the lead strips are fixed, I just applied some glue gun at the back of the adapter and fixed that. And now I will use some wire. I have a 2-meter wire here, and the reason I have a wire is because this will give me more mobility if I want to kind of move my camera around away from the plug point. This is going to give me more mobility, and for that I just have to join the two wires. And I want you to be careful with this, of course. I also have this plug pin, so that of course I'll need to plug this inside. I can't put naked wires inside, that will risk a shock obviously. And to do this, you need to open the pin, and there will be 2 pins just as shown here in the video. And all you have to do is take out the insulation from the wire and fix the wire on the 2 pins. And put it back. And because safety comes first, you also need to, I insulated it with a piece of electrical tape. You don't need to do this, but I'm just extra careful, and I also recommend you do this as well. Once this is done, we need to check our ring light, and there you can see it has lit up like a Christmas tree, which is very good, and the project is successful. Now we know that all the wiring is correct. Now we need to insulate any open wires, because safety comes first and you don't want to risk a shock. Now I have a microphone. Now because of that, you see, I can just mount my ring light on my microphone like that. When I don't have a microphone, then I remove my mic. I'm holding my phone with this, okay? And then what can I do is I can just place it here, and I'm going to use these. These are cable ties, and with this I'm going to fit. Okay guys, so my cable tie is too small for this, but what I mean is you can fix it by tying the cable tie, or these are even called zip ties, by tying this to one of the legs of your tripod, and then it won't move. Okay, so I need to get some larger cable ties.